Welcome to Grab and Go Info. In this tutorial, we will talk about how to create a Tableau scatter plot and animate it by category using autoplay. You will learn how to create a scatter plot using Tableau, how to add trend lines to scatter plot, how to add annotation to Tableau charts, how to automatically create charts by category and autoplay the charts. Let's get started. Tableau provides a wide variety of options for connecting to a data source. The file types Tableau can read include but not limited to Microsoft Excel, text file, JSON file, PDF file. Tableau can connect to different server types such as MySQL, Oracle, Amazon Redshift, and Google Drive. Please refer to my tutorial How to Connect Tableau to Google Drive for more details on Google Drive connection. In this example, we will use the sample dataset that comes with Tableau. To connect to the sample dataset called Superstore, click Sample, Superstore under Saved Data Sources. We would like to create a scatter plot to understand how sales changes with the quantity. Step 2.1, drag quantity to columns and sales to rows, and you will see one data point on the chart. Step 2.2, drag order date to detail and change year to day that represents the individual dates. After changing to day, each circle represents the sales and quantity of a single day. Step 2.3. Click the downward arrow next to automatic and select circle. Step 2.4. Drag region to color. We can see that the scatter plot now has four colors, and each color represents one region. Step 2.5. Click the color card and change opacity from 100% to 50%. Now we can see the overlapping circles. Step 2.6, drag distinct to size and we can see the circles of different sizes. A larger size means a bigger discount and a smaller size means a smaller discount. The size of the bubble can be adjusted by dragging the slide bar in the size card. To add trend lines to the scatter plot, right-click on the scatter plot, select trend lines, then show trend lines. You will see one trend line for each region. In step 4, we will animate the scatter plot by year to see how the data changes over the year. Step 4.1, drag order date to pages. Step 4.2, right-click the chart area, then go to annotate and select area. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. Tell me what tutorial you would like to watch in the comment. The next video may be based on your request. Step 4.3. In the Edit Annotation pop-up window, type Year. Then click Insert in the menu and select Page Name. Step 4.4. Format the annotation. I increased the text size from 10 to 24. After clicking the blue OK button, we can see the year showing up on the chart and a card for animation showing up on the right-hand side. We can move the annotation text around and change the size of the text box. Step 4.5, to remove the background of the annotation text box, right-click the annotation and select Format. A Format Annotation pane will show up on the left-hand side. Choose Shading and select None. And the annotation background became transparent. Step 4.6. Click the triangle to play the scatter plot by year, and select the number of bars to change speed. One bar means the speed is slow, two bars represents medium speed, and three bars represents fast speed. In this tutorial, we talked about how to create a Tableau scatter plot and animate it by category using autoplay. You learned how to create a scatter plot using Tableau, how to add trend lines to scatter plot, how to add annotation to Tableau charts, how to automatically create charts by category and autoplay the charts. If you prefer the written version of the tutorial, please check out my blog post. I will put the link in the video description. This is the blog post for this tutorial. It has all the screenshots and explanations in the video. To learn more about data science and machine learning, please subscribe to the channel and check out my YouTube playlist for visualization. Click the playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.